Freeze! Welcome to the channel Fix Your Mercedes. In this video, we're going to be talking something about the basics. This is the video for all of those that recently subscribed to the channel and that have maybe problems with their system. They heard that you need a pressure gauge, blah blah blah, and you have to measure the pressures, something like that. Well, this is the tutorial video on how to do that. Everyone of us once in his lifetime, let's say it like that, would have to measure the pressures. Let me explain you. You know this. You've seen this. This is called the fuel distributor. The pressure. There is one pressure that is created by the pump, which builds it up. And that pressure is called system pressure. There is another one, which is called working pressure. We must not have one pressure only at any cost. Why? Because if we had the same pressure both in the upper as well as in the lower chamber, then we would have no fuel flow at all towards the injectors. Not at all. That's why we have to decrease this pressure somehow. This pressure is decreased by this thing. This is called the electro-hydraulic actuator, the EHA. It's simpler. Well, and now that leads us to the second one, the second pressure, which is at the lower chamber. That is the working pressure, and here in the upper chamber, this one is called system pressure, the pressure coming from the pump. This EHA, this thing, decreases the pressure. And that leads us to third pressure, let's say it like that, that is called differential pressure. What does it mean, differential pressure? Well, just remember the origin of the word differential. It comes from the word difference, something that is not same. The pressure here is not same as the one here, logically. And that differential pressure must be 0.4 bar. This is crucial for you to understand. The moment you have 0.4 bar differential pressure, the difference between the system pressure and the control pressure, then you have the ideal pressure, the ideal difference in both pressures. Everything above 0.4 bar is called rich mixture. 0.5, 6, 7, 8. Everything below 0.4 bar is a lean mixture, 0.3, 2, etc. As I was talking in my videos, now let me show you how you can check that pressure. For the system pressure to check it, you will have to unscrew this fitting for the cold start valve, and here you will have to fit or to screw in the pressure gauge. So you do it like this, and then you start your car and you read this pressure. Afterwards, as you do that, you unscrew this fitting. Now let me show you something. The working pressure you will have to measure here on the lower chamber. Now you unscrew this one, be careful, you have a aluminum washer. Now look at this. This is the fitting for the differential pressure I was talking about. This is the line that goes to the fuel pressure regulator. Watch. Here, boom! And now, watch this. Just a moment, please. Boom! Here. You see that? Now, as you mount your pressure gauge on the lower chamber, now you start the car. Of course, you must get back the metal pipe for the cold start valve. And then you start your car. And here you read your working pressure. There, as I have already told you, you must get this difference between the pressures of 0.4 bar. And that would be some basics for you to learn and to do. That's nothing to be afraid of, either rich or lean mixture. That's something that is here controlled on the AHA. But that would be a story for some next time. So my dear ones, if you enjoyed this video, then please don't click the button skip ad. It is going to help me a lot. And till the next video, happy Mercedesing. Bye.